On May 24th, President Yoweri Museveni issued Executive Order No. 3 of 2023, banning charcoal trade in northern and northeast Uganda, which resulted in widespread scarcity of charcoal. Since the ban, charcoal prices have leaped from 55,000 shillings to 80,000 shillings per bag, which has caused anxiety from the public. Now the Parliamentary Committee of Climate Change, chaired by Lawrence Biyika Songa, is seeking a total ban on the export of charcoal.
Charcoal ban, total ban. There is a motion prepared already by this committee to ban charcoal export, but not local use. Because when we are banning here completely, we must have alternatives. There is no way someone who is using firewood and then you say, from today onwards, we want you to use electricity.
Songa explained that since Kenya imposed a ban on charcoal burning, a number of trucks have been ferrying charcoal from Uganda to Kenya and other neighboring countries, which must stop. He believes this ban will enable Ugandans to access cheaper charcoal on the market and reduce pressure on the trees.
We don't have the exact statistics unless we can get them from the books, but what we know is charcoal is leaving Uganda. These days they say even they cover them in these big trailers that are coming from the coast, they put charcoal there. So we really, because now if Kenya is banned charcoal, but when you go to Kenya now, you will see households using charcoal. So where do they get the charcoal from if they have banned charcoal in the country?
According to the Committee of Climate Change, the ban on charcoal trade and burning is far-fetched because Ugandans were not prepared enough with alternative fuel.
Say we are banning, we are putting a total ban on charcoal production in the country. Charcoal for production for home use in Uganda should still be allowed and it should be gradual. But now if you know that you're using charcoal in your home, why don't you plant at least 20 to 100 trees around your home? It will help you for windbreaks, it will help you for poles.
Now the committee wants government to waive taxes on gas cylinders to make use of petroleum gas affordable for use. They also want the same to apply on solar panels.
But what is still making gas cooking very expensive is there is no, we are still charging. We have not removed the VAT on cylinders. There was some initiative from Ministry of Energy to give gas cylinders. We shall call them also to track the progress.
According to reports, Uganda loses 120,000 acres of forest cover annually, a trend that has been growing over the years. The Uganda Forest Authority states that forest cover has continued to decrease due to unsustainable human activities led by charcoal burning. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.